We are the Jazz and Salsa Band, which means we do jazz, traditional big band jazz, as well as contemporary salsa. And we're going to start out as a jazz band. We're going to do three tunes for you. We're going to do the traditional standard, Sweet Georgia Brown, a very cool, slow, swinging take on When You're Smiling, and then another jazz standard on Green Dolphin Street. We've got lots of music we want to share with you tonight. So we're going to go ahead and do those three as a little set. Sound good, band?
Yeah.
Obviously, I'll count us in tonight. We're not just going to segue. Here we go. Sweet Georgia Brown. Opening up with Brandy on the Vibes. Thank you. Okay, so back there on Sweet Georgia Brown, we are from Brandy and Eric, saxophone. When You're Smiling, again, Eric on tenor and Brandy on fills. And then Green Dolphin Street, Arisha on alto saxophone and Fong on trumpet. Yeah. So one of the things we're doing tonight is we're going to share some pictures. You know what, Jared? Go ahead and fire them up. If this all comes together as planned. I was frantically moving photos from one thing to another about a half an hour before we started. Yeah, okay, so here's some pictures from our trip to Puerto Rico. This band, well, some of this band, who went? A lot of this band went to Puerto Rico in January, and we made it there through donations from folks like you, from a very generous grant from the Associated Students of Edmonds College. And we held an auction, we had a dance here in the fall, and we were able to take 16 people to San Juan, Puerto Rico in January. And I thought first I'm just gonna read the itinerary. These are the things we did. We arrived on a Friday. For Saturday and Sunday, we attended the San Sebastian Street Festival, which is in Old San Juan. Anybody been to Puerto Rico out there? You know about Old San Juan. You don't go there without going to Old San Juan. Well, in January is one of the biggest festivals of the year, the San Sebastian Street Festival. Stages all over, lots of music, lots of art, and it's a really amazing time to connect with the Puerto Rican culture. And so we did that for 2 days. It's like 200,000 people crammed into Old San Juan. It's a huge party, and we get to hear the best bands from all over the island. Then on Monday, what did we do? Oh yeah, I've taken groups. I took a group to Havana, took a group to Puerto Rico before, and I've always just gone focused intently on music and culture, and this time we thought, well, and because the tour people floated it to us, maybe we should go snorkeling. So we did. We took a half a day, and we got on a catamaran, and we did some snorkeling in a couple spots. That's what we did on Monday. And then Monday night, we went to, it's a neighborhood performance. They just get together and play of bomba and plena, which are the local styles in Puerto Rico. So we got to hear some truly authentic bomba playing. Bomba connects strongly with African traditions. And it's great, you know, that almost every night throughout the week, we were going to places that most tourists just don't know about. I spent 4 weeks in Puerto Rico in 2014 on a sabbatical doing Spanish language immersion and studying salsa, piano, composition. And so I got to know these folks at this little language school, and that's who helped us set up this tour. So like, okay, Monday nights you got to go to Bonanza and hear the bomba, and so it's really an amazing experience. It's an amazing place. Okay, so that's Monday. Tuesday, we did our walking tour. Yep, walking tour of Old San Juan, touring the original Spanish forts that are there. Been there since the 16th century. And then Tuesday night went and caught live jazz, again at a local little pub, little bar, outdoor area. And these were students from the local university, jazz musicians, and they were absolutely top-notch, world-class players. Ronan and I all night were like, there's the top of the form, I think. And we're like checking in with each other. There's the top of the form.
Also finding the
Yeah, just finding downbeats. I mean, these kids were just cooking. And it was just bass, drums, and a saxophone. And they were messing with time and messing with changes, and they were fantastic players. I went and talked with the bass player afterwards, super humble kid. I mean, these were just kids. Amazing, amazing musicians all over that place. Wednesday, we had a lecture on the history of music in the Caribbean. From a guest lecturer from the local
college in the area where the language school is. And then we went to the music conservatory. You'll see us, we're gonna let these just run as we play our salsa tunes. You'll see us with some musicians in a small classroom, and I'm playing a little teeny guitar. It's a cuatro, Puerto Rican cuatro. So that was at the Conservatory of Music. We sat in with their traditional folk ensemble. Well, we didn't sit in, we just observed that one. Small folkloric group where they play mostly plena styles. The cuatro is it was originally a four-string guitar, and then they doubled the strings, then it had eight strings, and then they added another string, so then it had 10 strings, but they didn't change the name. It's still called a cuatro, even though it's got 10 strings. So it's just cuatros, guitar, bongos, is that it?
And the early day
cajon.
And cajon, yeah, right. And then that evening, Wednesday evening, we came back for a concert by the faculty of, and it was a concert of a survey of music of the Americas played by the faculty at the conservatory. That was a great concert. Included even some Brazilian stuff, South American styles too. Oh yeah, that was a big day. Then we went and caught the rumba at that other bar. We caught a live rumba. Rumba is another tradition that connects strongly with African styles and African influence. We're gonna play rumba at the beginning of our last piece tonight. More on that in a bit. And then Thursday, what did we do? Oh yeah, Thursday was the big the art and bomba day. So we visited a painter, his home studio, way out in the countryside. And you'll see some of those pictures go by. He's a very famous, very successful painter. And just beautiful stuff. And he uses a lot of bomba dancers in his art. So that was really special to get to tour his home studio. And then we had a class on bomba drumming and bomba dancing. And then, oh yeah, and then a live salsa band. And that was cool, it was really more of a club situation, so it was really loud. But this amazing band that had just a keyboard player who was playing bass, and then one percussionist who was playing a combination of congas and bongos and timbales all at once, filling in bells, making timbale fills, and that was really cool. So very much a live salsa club night on Thursday night. Friday, we had a workshop with some professional salsa musicians. We spent a couple hours with them. Wonderful, interactive, really energetic, that flute player guy. He was just old fella, but man, full of energy, just bouncing off the floor. And was teaching the horn players stuff by rote, like just singing them lines, walking up the trumpets, okay, singing them a line, singing the saxophones, getting everybody involved. You'll see, I think Ronan's in one of these pictures standing there with the rhythm section. And then we had a rumba workshop. We focused on playing a specific style, wawanko, which is a rumba style. This style of rumba and wawanko comes through Cuba. And it's based on a particular clave. I'll talk a little bit about that when we go to play some rumba for you in a little while. And then we went and caught the rumba teacher. His band performed at the same place that we went to on Tuesday, so we went and got to see another live rumba performance, which was fantastic. Saturday, what did we do? We went to a music store, and then we went to an airport. And we flew home. It was a very full week. So those of you who are here or who are listening at home or seeing this this video later on who supported us in this trip, we are so grateful for it. It was a fantastic experience. And I think there are a couple of us who wants to come up and just say a word or two about their time in Puerto Rico.
My name's Jackson.
Right up on that.
Yeah, okay, all right. So, yeah, my name's Jackson. I'm actually a running start student. And I just want to say how incredibly thankful I am to have had the opportunity to go on that trip. I mean, it was just really being immersed in the culture over there, and just, I mean, music just is part of the culture. It's just everywhere you go, there's music. That's just how it is. I mean, it doesn't matter. You could be in a fast food restaurant it doesn't matter. The music will find you. It's just, there's always this groove going. And that was just, it was a really cool experience to just be able to always just feel like the heartbeat of Puerto Rico going. Thank you, everybody who made this possible.
Yeah. Who else is going to say something? Eric? Sanchez?
Sure.
Yeah. Sure.
Sure.
We did talk about this.
Hi. So this was my second time going to Puerto Rico. I went with the band back in 2020, right before the whole COVID thing happened. So I think what I found most like great about Puerto Rico this time is I was expecting for it to be a little less like magical, I guess, because I felt like I got to experience a lot of it last time we went, and then I really like went out and like listened to a lot of the music when I came back home in those 3 years that we were back home, you know. And I felt like once we went back, it just felt like completely fresh still. Like you went over there and you get to listen to this music and it's just completely different to listen to the recordings. Especially that Wednesday night Roomba thing, that was just crazy. I never listened to it. I mean, like you listen to the recordings, but that thing was just a completely different animal live. But yeah, I think that was the most cool thing about it. And thank you for contributing to the trip.
Sam, the singer, he's faculty in the music department and sings with us regularly. He's going to sing tonight. He was with us on the trip.
Yeah, I went in 2020 as well, and this trip, this last January. And so I just mainly want to say thank you to all that supported our young people, because I mean, we old people, we learned a lot too. But the young people, they just got to have a whole new experience and experience a whole culture, and it was amazing for all of us, but I was really just so grateful and happy for our young people to get to have that. I was jealous because I was like, oh, if I could have done this at 19, right? So it was amazing. Thank you for supporting that. Yeah, it was a fabulous trip. Fabulous trip. And I want to hop on what Jackson was saying about the music just pulsing. I mean, really, from the moment you step off the plane, there is just this groove. It just grooves and grooves and grooves. And it doesn't matter where you are. And people are moving. There's kind of the basic salsa step is this, you do it in one direction and going back. And that feeling, if you're at a concert, even if people aren't dancing, you look around and you realize, oh, everybody's doing this. And you find that you're doing this for a week straight. So imagine growing up there. You know, it would be in the bones. Would you play a B minor, B flat minor chord? There's a note, there's a note, there's a note. I'm throwing an audible at you. We're actually going to have the percussion start, then we're going to sing. I just want you to hear the beat first. So this isn't really how this chart starts, but it just seems like the right moment to just have the percussion play a little. Let's play down. At the core of any salsa groove is the clave. And the clave is an instrument. They're the two sticks that you smack together. But it's also the rhythm that those sticks play. This is called a 2-3 clave. Thank you.
Buenas noches. Now, I'm just going to say this once I'll make the invitation. Do with it what you will. When you hear this music, I don't know how people sit still to it, because I just can't. So I'm not going to be standing still. So if you want to get up and dance, can I invite them to do that?
Absolutely.
Vamos a bailar. That's what that last song said. That means we're about to dance. Yeah. So, all right, John. All right, Juanito.
Sí. Vámonos. El Cuarto de Cuba. This is a traditional Cuban song, a story about a young girl who fell asleep and forgot to blow the candle out, and so she burned the house down. If you've ever listened to the Buena Vista Social Club, this song's on that, just on that soundtrack. One, two, one, two, three.
En el barrio la cachimba se ha formado la corredera. En el barrio la cachimba se ha formado la corredera. Allá fueron los bomberos con sus campanas rugideras. Allá fueron los bomberos con sus campanas rugideras. Ay, mamá, ¿qué pasó? En el barrio la cachimba se ha formado la corredera. Allá fueron los bomberos con sus campanas usineras. Allá fueron los bomberos con sus campanas usineras. Ay, mamá, ¿qué pasó? Ay, mamá, ¿qué pasó?
Thank you. got it. Let's sing it. Let's sing it. Cuanto de tula.
Sam, you cool to launch right into another powerhouse number while
you're
out there? Let's do it. One of the things about Sam Fijado is that he sings a wicked Stevie Wonder. So when I heard the Pacific Mambo Orchestra at Jazz Alley play this chart, a salsa arrangement of Stevie Wonder's Overjoyed, I thought, Sam needs to sing that.
Who was old enough in this house to remember Overjoyed? Stevie Wonder. Okay, all one of you? Oh, mm-hmm. Three of you? Okay.
Yeah, this is another killer chart. Let's hear it for Sam, huh? Yeah. Woo.
Believe you two might be overjoyed.
find. I have found what I searched to discover. I come not too far for me now to find. The love that I sought can never be mine. And though you don't believe that they do,
we should have closed with that one. Okay, we're gonna invite up some singers from Soundstation, from our vocal jazz ensemble, Soundstation. Here they come. We have Sam and Joffrey and Clara and Kiara. And if you ever have Clara and Kiara in your class at the same time, you are bound to say the wrong name again and again.
Give the wrong person the wrong grade.
Yeah, give the wrong, exactly. Or maybe give the wrong person the right grade, who knows.
Do we use your mic?
Yeah.
Okay, so this next piece is a piece I composed while I was in Puerto Rico during my sabbatical. Like I said, in 2014, I went there and studied Spanish and studied salsa piano and composition. And I spent a lot of time alone reading a lot of books. I was translating a lot of lyrics of different songs. It's one of the ways I was practicing my Spanish. And taking a lot of notes about my experience. And so I poured all that into this piece. And that fall of 2014 was the first quarter that we had the salsa band. So we launched the salsa program was in the fall of 2014. So this will be the second time this piece has been performed. First time was that fall. A little bit about the lyrics. It's called Esta Isla, which means this island. And so it's basically, it really is a narrative of my experience there. It starts out, and it's all in Spanish, so I'm going to throw just some nuggets at you. I live on this little island, and I see lovers under the palm trees. I hear the coqui. Those who've been to Puerto Rico, you know about the coqui. Coqui, that's this little frog. The coqui and the coqui are hiding and singing songs of love and freedom. The main hook for the piece is on this island. Busqué la música en esta isla, encontré que ella la tenía conmigo, which is, I searched for music on this little island, I found it was with me all along. And it's a connection that I've made in a lot of my travels, but especially with this music, both hanging with Cuban people and Puerto Rican people, whenever I use the term, your music, they go, no, it's our music. And it just slays me at the time. So that really is that's the main core of the hook you'll hear in the piece. It's really about how I discovered myself within the music of Puerto Rico. So this is Esta Isla.
One, two, one, two, three.
should have closed with that one. Yeah, let's do two more. Well, it's really kind of one big one. Very cool. Thank you all for being here. We talked a little bit about some of the workshops we did. One of them was the Roomba workshop. We also saw two different live Roomba performances. Roomba comes in a number of different styles and grooves. Probably the most common one you find in the salsa repertoire is a wawanko. Wawanko is based on what we call the Roomba clave, which our Roomba teacher says actually is the wawanko clave. But up here on the mainland, jazzers refer to this as the Roomba clave. So where you noticed that other one was 2-3, we were going Well, this is a 3-2, so we're going to switch those, put the 3 side first. So first we'll do the 3-2 son, which is the same clave we were just doing. Ready, and bop, 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 bop. So that's 3-2 son. To turn a son clave into a Roomba clave, you delay that third note, an eighth note, a little bit more. So it goes bop, 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 Roomba clave. Then you're going to hear a conga pattern between two drums, and that's what makes this the wawanko. This piece is called Mambo de la Luz, the Mambo of the Light, and it's bananas. Thank you.
bachata. Oye, cómo va. Mi ritmo puedo pa' gozar. Mulata. Thank you.